I open the SD card in my computer and there is data.txt. So I will check the content and there are many number in it. So this is the result of our data logging. So this is the Arduino, the SD card module and jumper wire. We know that SD card module uses SPI to communicate with Arduino. So there is MOSI, MISO, SCK and CK. And of course VCC and ground for the power. Okay, let's wire the SD card module with Arduino. We can use the jumper wire mail-to-mail to connect the SD card to the Arduino. There is VCC, MISO, MOSI, SCK and CK. I use the breadboard to make it easier to stick the SD card module. You can see the wiring diagram on the corner. So we just connect the Arduino and the SD card module like that. Okay, the wiring is down. Now it's time to try to connect the Arduino to computer. And don't forget to double check the wiring if you are not sure the wiring is correct. I plug the USB cable to the Arduino. And now it's time to program our SD card module. Okay, I will use the example from the library of SD card. It's the card info. We will test if the SD card module can read our SD card. Okay, make sure the chip select is 4 because it's only customizable pin for this communication. I'm uploading the program to the Arduino. Okay, we can open the serial monitor to test the SD card and there is error. The SD card is not read. So what happened? The SD card is not insert yet, so I will insert the SD card right now. It's 32 gigabytes of SD card, so I insert it to the SD card module and I will restart the Arduino. Okay, I press the reset of Arduino and bingo, our SD card now read by the SD card module. So our wiring is actually correct and now the SD card module is working. And the serial monitor is showing the list of files in our SD card. Okay, now it's time to learn how to create file, open file, delete file, and the last is how to lock the data. Okay, I just create new Arduino file and we will code it from scratch. The first is include the library, of course there's an SPI and SD, and then I will make the file object, it's called test. Okay, I will print the SD init at the first time of the running of Arduino. And then I will initialize the SD card and check the wiring if the wiring is correct. The program will say init pilot if there is error in the SD card, and will continue the init OK when the SD card is connected. Before we create a file, we will check if the file is already exists in the SD card. To do this, we just need to type the syntax if sd.exist and the name of file. It will print yes, that is exists if there is file name testing.txt, and will print nope, that is not if there is no file with the name testing.txt. After check the file, we can create the file. Wait, before we continue this video, please subscribe and turn on the notification to make us more excited to make another video. We create the file using syntax sd.open and then file name and file write. Okay, so sd.open can create a file if there is no file name testing.txt, but if there is one, it will just open the file. So to create the file, I just sd.open testing.txt file write and then test.close. That means that I close the file after creating the file. After we create the file, we will test if the file already exists again. Use the same syntax as we do before. And to delete file, you can use the syntax sd.remove and the name of file. In this case, I will sd.remove testing.txt. And then we will check again if the file testing.txt is removed or erased from our SD card. And finally, our testing is done. Then we upload the program to Arduino and open our shadow monitor to check it. So it print SD card init okay. Okay, the initialization is complete, and then nope, there is not the first try. We check the file is not exist, that's true, and then we create the file. Then we check again and yes, that is exists. So we success create the file, and then we delete the file and check again and nope, that is not. So the file then deleted and the testing is done. So we have success try to open, create and remove the file from our SD card. That is the basic syntax of this SD card module. Now we will try to log the data, save the data into txt file in the SD card. I will erase the program and left the SD card initialization and rename the file to data. And in the loop, I will create the random number between 0 and 10. This is to demonstrate the data from the sensor, but in this case I just use the random number. And then I convert the integer to string so it can be stored on the SD card. I open the file and then I print the string data to the file. It's data print line string data, and then I close the file and I will print the data in the serial monitor too. Sorry, I should put the tipo data on the front. And I open the serial monitor to test it. And every data in the serial monitor will start in the SD card too. I will open my SD card with my computer so we can check if the file is recorded or saved on my SD card. I open the SD card in my computer and there is data.txt. So I will check the content and there are many number in it. So this is the result of our data logging, and this means that our SD card is saved our data from the Arduino. Okay, that is our tutorial about how to use the SD card module with the Arduino. Thank you for watching and see you in another tutorial. Bye.